Now I'm going to start working on that field of blue bonnets. I'm going to put a little bit of light here in front of my building just to help bring the eye back to this little homestead back here. Right now my flowers look really bright in that rock garden. But once I start getting the foreground flowers in, they're going to drop back. The colors are actually pretty muted. They just don't look like it right now because all the color around them is so blue and soft greens and stuff. Once I start getting this orange and deep reds and all the different colors up here, that's going to fall back. So I start in the distance of my field. I just start working forward, and I put some little places where grass and stuff is showing through the blue bonnets. I first painted that just with a mix of ultramarine blue plus dioxinine purple plus white. And dioxinine purple is just a really nice purple that we just are not able to mix with this color palette. So I use that, and it's a real cool color. It drops back and adds some interest back into that back part of the field. Bring some of, using some of my color left over from the sky, I pop some of that back there. Just gives the impression of some little white poppies back there in the distance. We'll have some pure white ones up here in the foreground, but just kind of helps tie the colors all together. Now coming forward, I start using some ultramarine blue plus white. So this is a little color is a little more intense, so it starts just walking forward. Blue bonnets are a spring ritual in Texas. Everybody that we live here, we know spring has arrived when you start seeing the blue bonnets. It's like, ah, winter's over. Now we can pull out the flip-flops and the shorts and because it's going to be hot pretty soon. It's our Texas state flower. And we just are very proud of our fields of blue bonnets. Boy, in a good wildflower year, the hillsides are just blanketed with blue bonnets and Indian paintbrush, and God has just treats us with a cornucopia of color. There's no way as artists we can even get close to matching his beauty, but we get there. We try anyway, we don't get there. We strive to come halfway close, which we don't do, but I love painting blue bonnets. I just kind of mush a bunch of color around. Again, I'm still working with the ultramarine blue plus white. I've got two shades, a darker shade and then a lighter shade. I'm going to have some red penstemon in here that's going to be popping up in front of those blue bonnets. Now I'm coming in with a little cobalt blue plus white. And see, that's a warmer blue. Comes forward. I'm going to let some of my blue bonnets come in between the little California poppies and Indian paintbrush. Flowers kind of grow in clumps and in between each other and just neat bunches, so have some different variations. Again, this side's going to, I'm going to have white poppies growing in there, but get this canvas covered I'm going back to my ultramarine blue. And I use toilet tissue to clean my brush. If you have a clean brush, then your color on the canvas stays nice and clean. The image extends around the sides of the canvas. I'm just kind of putting some paint there. I'll come back and kind of work that area more. Just kind of getting them covered. Now, what I'm going to start doing is start working some darker greens and my foliage colors in between the blues where I've left the white spots. And as I go back, I use cooler mixtures. These are mixes of phthalo blue plus a little cadmium orange plus white. And that's cooler so that that foliage goes back. Again, cool colors go back, warm colors come forward. Got a little bit of phthalo blue plus liquid mixed up that I just kind of used for my dark, pop back in some little dark accents here and there in between clumps of flowers. It's not just a solid green. Now as I'm coming forward, my greens get warmer. This has a little more cadmium yellow medium mixed into that previous mixture of the phthalo blue plus cadmium orange plus white. So I need to mix a little bit more of that phthalo blue and liquid. And just this little darkness starts giving the plants a base. There's going to be some flowers in there, so some oranges. So I'm going to have a little clump of other flowers right in there. So I'll look the blue bonnets around that. Matter of, at this point, when I'm blocking in the blue bonnets, it's just kind of getting color up there and smooshing it around. Real technical term, but that's basically what I'm doing. So, kind of give some little variations within the darks. And I'm going to make the foliage here come back in and bring this area darker. Because those red, I want that a little darker back there, so when I put those red penstemon in there, those cadmium orange light highlights will really pop against those dark, cool colors behind. So, our field of blue bonnets is blocked in. We're not anywhere near done yet, but this is blocked in. That's the start.